Okay, all you fellow believers in Nibiru and my friends and subscribers, have I got a video for you today? Folks, I've actually got a feeling Nibiru may have come and gone. Or, if it wasn't, it was a rogue planet. So either way, this planet, when you see it in a few moments, now, it would have to at least be 4 to 5 times larger than Jupiter. That's a very large planet coming in close proximity to our sun, so much that it actually affected the sunlight in between the stereo behind. I'm still trying to track down where stereo behind was and where our sun was and where Earth was on this particular date. I've got some friends looking into it for me, and hopefully pretty soon I'll be able to put a video out that will match this and everything so people can see the correlation of where this planet was. All those little white specks you're actually seeing are what they call space debris, but are moon-sized objects, by the way, a moon-sized space, so-called space debris. Now, look at that, folks. Now, watch this. You'll see, bang, it's actually passed on this side of the sun. Now, the way the stereo looks back at the sun, right, now, our Earth can be anywhere within an orbit, but if our sun or our planet went past the thing, it wouldn't affect it in this way because it would go behind the sun. It would not affect the forthcoming rays of sunlight coming towards the stereo telescope. This object actually passed in between the sun and the telescope, so it means this was not in orbit of our sun. If you notice the elliptical pattern that's actually going around our sun at the time, you'll notice that something is wrong. Now, if you look at it, it's in a curved motion, right? It's heading too steeply for our sun, which is another thing as well. And bang, there it goes. And it turns in a circular motion. Now, to me, that is not in an elliptical or a circular orbit of our sun. It's a very, very large planet. And I mean, it's a very large planet, folks. And the thing is, there's something going on with this planet. At the very end of the video, I'm going to put a blown-up shot, no sound, not me talking, of the planet just in about that position there. That's that quick flash. I don't know why it's doing that. It's sort of, I stuck it in the wrong position, I suppose, in the film. But the thing is, it's sort of what you're actually seeing within that video is actually the sun going in and being interfered with by this planet. Now, this is either a rogue planet or it's Nibiru. Now, but it's, the thing is, it's in the wrong type of orbit for it to going around the sun. If it was going around the sun, it would not go in front of the sun. And if it was going around the sun, it would have a different type of orbit pattern. Now, that to me is quite intense. Now, this is not orbiting the sun. This is orbiting, looks more like it's orbiting the telescope. So, in other words, it's not orbiting our sun. So it says, okay, we either have a rogue planet or we have Nibiru. Now, this is 2007. Now, this could account, this planet in this orbit could account for about the 4 years, I think since about 2002 or 2003, we've had a lot of mega disasters going on around the world. Right up until this year, we've had major disasters. Now, this planet could be something that actually caused it. It could have caused disasters. We don't know, right? We don't know the effects of what a major planet this size could do. Now, I actually have other videos as well where the actual air, something else is affecting the area around the sun as well. Now, I don't know what they could be, but the thing is, something is going on. This planet does not belong in our solar system. Or if it is in our solar system, it's something we've never seen before and we've never been told about. Now, the thing is, there is something truly going on. Why is this planet in our atmosphere? what is it doing in our atmosphere? Our atmosphere, I take that one back. I mean in our solar system. It is in the wrong type of orbit to be one of our planets. So what is going on? Why is it moving in front of the sun in a circular motion as if it's orbiting the telescope and not the planet? If it was going around the planet, you would see it with a different type of orbit. I have looked at all the possible scenarios of IE, we're just looking at it coming in and it's orbiting on a funny orbit. But if it's orbiting on a funny orbit, why is it orbiting in front of the sun? Okay, this could be one of these second suns. Now, I do think there was a second sun back in 2007. This could be one of the second sun's planets. Now, as I've told everybody in my second sun videos, right, that we get second suns passing our planet on a numerous occasion. Now, this could just be from a star that came near our star, and it could be one of its planets just happening to get pulled over by our sun, but its main planet could still be enough to actually pull it back. I don't know, okay? I don't have enough information yet myself. But I do have enough information to put it out there and show you that there was a rogue planet in the wrong kind of orbit passing in front of our sun. And it's a planet, and it's bigger than Jupiter. It's at least 4 to 5 times the size of Jupiter. That sun, that ring, that white ring there, that is the current position of our sun, and it is also the size of our sun. And yet this planet comes along in front of our sun in the wrong position, right, in the wrong style of orbit, with hundreds and hundreds of moon-size little dots running around. Those little dots are the size of our moon, by the way. Now, this is all going on around our sun at any given time. But the thing is, then all of a sudden we get a rogue planet. Now, we have had a lot of natural disasters going on and on and on very recently. We have had a lot of second sun sightings. Now, if we had a second sun in conjunction close enough to our Earth, and there's plenty of evidence to prove we are getting second suns from the SOHO telescopes, right, and from all the people filming the second suns. There was one this morning, but unfortunately I didn't have my camera set up right and I couldn't capture it. But there is actually evidence of it on SOHO, and I've caught that evidence as well. That's going to be in one of my next two vids. But the thing is, a lot of this research out there, you don't get told about, right? And it's only through me being a solar researcher and sticking my time into space and researching space and UFOs that people like me do find these images. Someone else actually did find, I saw a picture of this sun, so I went hunting for it. And I actually found there was more than one picture because it was actually in an orbital pattern of more like something else than our sun. Now here it is again, it's coming in from the side. Now watch the orbit pattern. Here it is, it's passing in front of our sun. Watch what happens. We get an eclipse effect, so it is not in front of our thing. This is not an earthbound telescope, so it's not our moon, folks. This is not our moon, because our Earth is well away from these telescopes. The way the stereo behind telescopes are set up, this could not be our moon, this could not be one of our planets, and it's definitely not Jupiter. If this is Jupiter, something's going on. But the thing is, it is a rogue planet. Hence, it could be Nibiru. This could actually be Nibiru. This could be that dark planet that I actually have in one of my other videos. Now, a lot of others have been saying they've been seeing Nibiru. They're seeing these little red stars and everything like that because they hear that Nibiru is a red star because they're listening to the wrong people. I'm sorry, Nibiru is a planet to everybody else. This is a planet, folks. Notice how it's dark. There's no light coming from it. That's what a planet looks like. To see a planet, you need a star to see a planet. Now, you'll see a planet here. Now, watch it go in front of the sun. We get in. And now, look at the size of that planet. Eclipse. So it is passing between the sun and our telescope. But look at the orbital pattern. It's coming back towards the satellite. So in other words, this is not, and I say it emphatically, this planet is not in orbit of our sun. So something is going on. What is it? Why is this planet not in orbit of our sun? Because it doesn't belong there. It's a rogue planet. And it's large. It's bigger than Jupiter. It's 4 to 5 times the size of Jupiter. We most probably could fit a couple of thousand Earths inside that damn thing. Because that is a very big planet. This really could be Nibiru. It could have passed and we may have not even known about it. It could explain all these disasters, all these major flooding and everything that we're getting. And another thing, right, because we seem to get floods and everything on generally on a 50 to 100 year pattern. Maybe it's this rogue planet in its own orbit that comes past every now and then, every 50 or so years, causing all the drama that we're getting. And they've most probably known about it for years because they definitely know about it. There's no way NASA missed this image. There is no way in the wide world they missed this image. Right, they most probably think that we're going to pass it off as just one of our planets. But then if you look at the way it's going around, the orbital pattern, hence where the stereo behind sit in our atmosphere, and because they're looking at the sun, the orbital pattern looks more like it's orbiting the satellite rather than the planet, says it's not one of our planets, folks. So the government, again, has lied to you. I think we should rename NASA. I really think we should never associate science again. Because NASA doesn't associate with science. NASA, you associate NASA with lies. And why didn't they tell us about this? This would have been big news. A rogue planet passes through our solar system in 2007. What is going on, NASA? Stop bloody lying to the people. Tell the truth, NASA. And I'm going to put a separate image of this planet at the very end. I'm not even going to put any narration to it, just so you all can see it. There is something really, truly going on, folks. And it's about time they told us what is going on. Now, it's up to you people. You need to start pressuring your governments to start telling the truth. I'm not just talking to Australians, I'm talking to Americans, I'm talking to every single country in the world. It's time for the truth. Let the truth come out. This is Anthony Avery signing off once again. Okay, now these last couple of images, these are the two images I'm going to leave you with at the end. This little image you're currently looking at is actually something extra I did find on the Soho in these images just after I finished the last narration, so I thought I'd put it up. This is another little planet that's actually in orbit at around about the same period of time. You can see the time scales on the pictures. This is a blow-up of the shot. You can't see that picture. I don't know where that is, actually, the other one, because you can't see the dates on these two. So sorry about that. I just said I was not going to narrate, but so that's the planet, the size of it. There's another little planet, and that's a little planet. It's a different planet altogether. So, yeah, I'm going to leave them with you, and take it away, show your kids, and tell them the truth. Tell them that there's things going on in the universe that we don't get told. Our universe is much larger and greater than we know. So, yeah. This is Anthony Avery, a truth teller, out here telling the truth, finding the hard truth, and getting it to the public. Good luck.